Hello and welcome to this edition of Stay Fit with CNBC-TV18. This is Shibani Gharat. Now, marathon season is at its peak. I'm sure you must have registered for a marathon or even a 21-kilometer or a 10-kilometer or a 5-kilometer run. Today, we're going to tell you 5 different stretches each that you should do before and after your run that are very, very crucial. And to teach us those stretches, we have Coach Daniel Vaz with us today. Daniel, so good to have you on the show.
Thank you. My pleasure.
We fondly call him Zico, by the way, and he's going to tell us these 5 stretches that we must do before and after your race.
Okay, what we need to do is stretch in such a way that we are functionally using muscles which are going to be used in running. So you don't stretch to relax the muscle, but you use it in a dynamic movement form. They move the hips, the quads, the hamstrings.
Awesome. So let's go.
So the first stretch that you have is high knees. It gives you a warm-up as well as functionally moves the knees. The next functional dynamic stretch we're going to do is butt flicks. So you make sure that the heels come to the butt. Walking lunges, which mimic very closely what exactly you would do in a run. So you move forward, bring the knee down, up, down. The fourth one is going to open up your hips. So you're going to do a stretch like this. Put your foot down, 1, 2, 3. Other leg. And the fifth one is the glute stretch. So you're going to bring your knee to your chest and stretch the glutes. So like this. So 1, 2, 3. Other leg comes up. 1, 2, 3. And up, right? You just need to complete all of these stretches by moving for about 15-20 meters back and forth twice, and your muscles are ready for a run.
What are the post-run stretches that one can do?
Now you've completed your run, what you need to do is make sure that your muscles are ready to recover, which means that you need to relax those muscles. So now we're going to hold these stretches for a longer period of time, unlike what we did pre-run, okay? So the first one is the quad stretch. Your quads are going to be tight after the run. So you're going to hold your instep, balance yourself, hold the quad stretch. Yes, you need to hold it for around 15-20 seconds. And then the other leg. And next one is the hamstring stretch. So what you need to do is take a small step forward. Both your knees need to be locked and you lean forward, bend from the waist, don't round your back. Hold your shins or your ankles, depends on your flexibility, and you will get a hamstring stretch.
Okay.
Okay. So you hold that for 15-20 seconds, the same thing
Change
you do.
Change the leg and do it.
With the other leg. The third stretch that we are going to do is the hip flexor stretch, because the hip flexors which are located here are going to be tight after the run. So you take a long step forward, the rear leg should be straight, body upright, yes, and you should feel the stretch here. The same thing with the other leg.
Okay.
All right, 15, 20, 30 seconds, the muscle gets relaxed. The fourth stretch we're going to do is for the groin. So you move into a kind of a sumo squat. You hold your ankles. You use your elbows to move the thighs apart. And you hold the stretch. So you should be able to feel a groin stretch. And the final stretch, of course, is for your calves, because they take the most beating in the run. So you need to take a step forward. Bend the front knee. Keep the rear leg heel on the ground, and you should be able to get a calf stretch. And then the other leg. Now I'm going to show you another trick to be able to stretch the Achilles tendon, which is just below the calf.
Okay.
So you straighten this knee and you bend the rear knee.
So essentially, exactly what you did before, you have to do the opposite
of that. The reverse of it. Yes. So 15-20 seconds, you hold that stretch, and you're done.
So we did five stretches that you do before a run. We did five stretches that you do after your marathon or the run. Zico, I want to understand from you, what should be the recovery like after a race? On the day of the race and then probably for a week.
Okay, the first thing you need to do is make sure that your fluid intake is adequate as soon as you finish the race. Within 1 to 2 hours of finishing the race, you need to eat a carbohydrate and protein meal because the carbohydrate will replenish the carbohydrate stocks that you had lost in the race, and the protein is needed to repair muscle tissue that's been damaged. Subsequently, you need to have your meals and of course stay hydrated for the day. Over the next couple of days, what you need to do is make sure that you recover from your race, either going out for a walk the next day or going out for a short jog the next day.
All right. Thank you so much. Thanks for sharing these tips and insights with us. I hope these tips will help you run a better race and prepare you better for your next race. That's it for now. Till I see you next time, sweat, smile, repeat.